Sans moi, tu mourrais de faim.
Non, de joie.
Un petit film sur une fille qui aime les crêpes et la danse.
When they begin the beguine, it brings back the sound of music so tender. It brings back the night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. I'm with you once more under the stars. And down by the shore an orchestra's playing. Even the palms seem to be swaying. When they begin the beguine, when they begin the beguine.
Hello, welcome back to my channel. I'm still in Provence, and so today I'm going to make le crêpe. Now, this is not the classic French recipe, but actually, you know, I speak to a lot of my French friends, and every family seems to have a slightly different version that they have grown up with, and like in many countries where there is an iconic national dish, it tends to be something that is very linked with nostalgia. You grow up having it with your family, and the way that your family cooks it feels like it is the only way. For me, I don't drink milk because, first of all, I take my coffee black and strong. And also, my sister is a nutritionist, and her specialization is in the gut, so digestion. I use yogurt with a bit of water for almost all of my baking recipes that necessitate milk, and it works for me quite well, because basically, if you're lactose intolerant, because there is bacteria in the yogurt, it sort of helps break down the lactose faster than, or easier than it would in milk. It's going to be easier on your digestion, which is always good. And also, I find that I've always got yogurt in the fridge, being a good Greek girl. When I make this recipe for myself at home, I do quite a healthy version. So I don't use any sugar. A lot of people think you need sugar in crepes. You don't really, because particularly if you're going to put on Nutella or maple syrup or anything like that. But if you're putting in a little bit of cinnamon, for example, that really gives it a natural sweetness. So as I was saying, anyway, I just use it with yogurt and eggs, a tiny bit of wholemeal or whole wheat flour, low carbs, high protein, and it becomes quite a healthy snack or a healthy breakfast. And then I just put it with fresh fruit on top. That's the recipe that I make for myself, and I'll put all the details in the recipe in the description box at the bottom of this video. Today, however, I'm going to make a version which is much more irresistible. This is kind of what I make, you know, when you have a lover who stays over at night and I wake up and make him breakfast. Or if I'm cooking for my family, as I am today, for a little afternoon tea. And I'm going to do a salted caramel sauce with some loquats, because I'm right under a loquat tree at the moment, and my father has been picking all of these loquats, so it's so lovely to cook with ingredients from the garden. This is my dream, to have a place where I could just grow everything that I cook with. So I'm going to do that, and then I might use maybe some crème fraîche. I don't know, maybe, we'll see. I'm going to record all of those lovely baking sounds for any of you who are ASMR fans. I love the sounds of cooking. I find them so sensual and so calming, so soothing. Tell me in the comments below if you agree, or if there is a particular sound that you like. Anyway, let's get started. When a recipe calls for melted butter, I often use what is called beurre noisette, or browned butter, literally translates as hazelnut butter. It's a way of cooking it that makes it taste like hazelnuts. Essentially, you're separating the butter fat and the milk solids and toasting them on a low heat. There is a small window between achieving a delicious depth of hazelnut flavor and an acrid burnt taste. You want to use a light colored pan so that you can really see the tone of the butter and remove it from the heat just when it goes light golden brown. Swirl your pan a little so the butter cooks evenly. Be sure to take all those hazelnut sediments because they're what's carrying that nutty flavor. Leave your butter to cool in a wide, shallow dish because we don't want it cooking the eggs in the batter by adding it now when it's hot. Take some water to mix with yogurt. Begin the batter with 4 eggs. The secret to crepe batter is achieving a smooth consistency. I don't want to bother using a KitchenAid or blender, and I find the best way to get smooth, velvety batter is to whisk your eggs directly into the flour before adding your milk or yogurt in my case. No lumps. Here I have my salt and cinnamon, cooled browned butter, yogurt and vanilla extract. You know when your batter is the right consistency if you can draw a line on your spoon and the two edges remain sharp. I like to pour my batter into a teapot to make for easy pouring later. Irrespective of what version of the recipe you're using, most cooks agree that the longer you leave the batter, the better. So if you can, I mean, even just 30 minutes, preferably overnight, but if you can, you leave the batter after you've made it because it's going to, you know, all that egg is going to absorb all of the flour. I mean, the ingredients change dramatically if you just let it rest. Basically what I tend to do, and here I'm telling you all my little seduction routine, is, you know, if I have a partner come over to stay the night, I will have the batter made the day before so that then I can just wake up in the morning and be all effortless and easy and it's ready to go, right? Because you know when you ask someone, when you're lying in bed with someone, this is my experience, you're lying in bed with someone and you say, more, would you like me to make some crepes? And for me it's no problem, I love cooking. There's pretty much no time of the day that I will say to you, no, I can't be bothered. I can always be bothered. But when I ask, you know, someone, you're lying in bed and you say, would you like me to make crepes? They say, no, it's too much trouble. So I like to have the batter made the day before so they can't say this. And I say, it's already done. I just have to get up and cook them. And also, why would you go out for brunch? I think it's so much more intimate to have breakfast at home, don't you think? And you know, outside you've got to wait, you've got to queue up, you're around lots of other people. You can't have breakfast in your pajamas or whatever else you're wearing. So yes, let's get started. Enough banter about my love life.
Live it again. It's past all endeavor.
Making caramel can be stressful, but here are my tips. A non-stick pan is not ideal. Use the heaviest quality pan you have. Thin, cheap pans cook sugar unevenly. Over low heat, let the sugar dissolve. You don't want the pan on high heat until the sugar has dissolved or it will crystallize and go hard instead of smooth and velvety. I find putting fruit in the pan with the butter and brown sugar helps because it keeps the sugar at a lower heat. There is no coming back from sugar crystals if you try to heat sugar too fast, so be patient. In France, they say the first crepe is always bad because the pan isn't hot enough. See how the butter doesn't bubble here? This is what you want. Quickly tilt the pan to spread your butter to create a delicate, tender crepe that will melt in the mouth at the softest chew. I ascertain whether it's ready to flip by seeing if I can hear the toasted underside when I slide the pan a little like this. Almost forgot the sea salt. Taste it when it's off the heat and see if you need to add some more. And we're ready.
The Beguine. Oh, yeah. yes, let them begin the beguine. Make them play till the stars that were there before return above you. Till you whisper to me once more, darling, I love you. And we suddenly know what heaven we're in when they begin the beguine. When they begin the beguine.
If you are enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps it to get seen. And if you didn't like it, if you're not enjoying it or you don't like me personally, are you a masochist? Why are you watching still at this point? You should click away and go and watch something else. The internet is a vast and diverse and beautiful place where you can certainly find someone who connects with you if I'm not connecting with you. Please subscribe. Thank you to everybody who is supporting me on Patreon. I'm not at my goal yet, so if you can, if you want to give anything, please head over to patreon.com/Kylie Flavelle. My videos will always be free, always. Oof. I want to give you the choice, and I know that a lot of people can't afford to support me. However, there are many artists out there, many YouTubers who like these people, who have 3,000, 5,000, 10,000 per video. There was one person who was a little bit negative and didn't think that it cost so much to put out these videos. And it actually, it's actually a wonderful thing. First of all, because some very kind-hearted people out there supported me and defended me. I hadn't even seen the comment, and then some lovely people, one girl in particular, really wrote a beautiful response in my defense, which I just, oh, this is so kind. And also, it gave me a great idea. I thought, you know what, I should do a video that itemizes every single detail of that you'll need if you're an expat moving to Italy, and how much it would cost to live, or how much it costs me to live. And that way, you can get an idea. I mean, I could also itemize for you just how many costs there are for me as a filmmaker to make this level of quality of production. You could say everyone wants to live in Italy. Yes, but is everyone offering a product or service for free with proof that people find it of value? I've managed to live in Europe for 10 years completely on my own as a freelancer, not asking anyone for help, doing a million jobs from being a dishwasher, a babysitter, a translator, signing international brands like Samsung and HP, being a motivational speaker at conferences, being one of the first people to make a TV show completely alone with no production company. The only reason I'm asking you now, and it is very difficult for me, is because I know I can offer you something of quality every week, and I've made you over 100 free videos to prove myself and let you test if my work adds any joy to your life. If we take a normal month, for example, when I put out the Story of Hope episode about the children with hemophilia and cancer, for which there were 7 hours of filmed interviews, any editor will tell you that is a lot of work. There was a train to get from Rome to Trento, multiplied by 2 for the return trip, phone data because Wi-Fi in my apartment isn't strong enough to upload, and it's a 20-minute episode, so I often need to be uploading overnight and can't sit in a Wi-Fi cafe, 2 Sennheiser microphones so I can record interviews because my cheap Rode ones kept breaking and don't give such crisp sound, which some of you have commented on in previous videos where the audio wasn't so good, SD cards with an ultra-high read-write speed so that I can shoot in 96 frames, which gives me slow motion. I film so much that I always run out of storage space, so I'm constantly buying new external hard drives. Royalty-free music licenses, because you always comment on how much it makes a difference to your mood, even though the majority of my music now I try finding for free. But every now and then there's just a particular song or a particular country's style of music that I need for a video. Editing software monthly membership, repairs to my computer so that I can have a faster machine so I can edit without long render times and not make you wait so long for my videos. Every month there are just random different costs. I don't drink, I rarely go out. Anytime you see me in a hotel, it's because I've hustled and negotiated a deal with the PR agency to make them promotional footage and photography in exchange for accommodation. All of that just to explain that there is a lot more behind the scenes that you don't see. And thank you to the people who value my work and trust me and would like to have an episode every week. Thank you for allowing me into your Sunday, into your weekend. I hope you're feeling positive about the week coming. Click here if you would like to support me on Patreon, and here if you would like to subscribe. And I shall see you next week.